this is the ABF head that I had.
Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. I am just using the car as a daily this week, just checking if there's any issues and trying to get it sorted and just to drive it. I'm on my way to do wheel alignment. I'm really hoping that I won't have to wait long and that they'll have a slot for me. Going to Good Hope Tires in Woodstock. Yeah, so it will be good to have the car aligned. I mean, the subframe and everything has been out, so things are definitely not as they should be. So yeah, I'm going to do that now. This is kind of how my steering wheel is when I'm driving, so it's quite skew. So, all good. Luckily, I could just pull up and get the car on. So I'm happy with the front ride height. It should be good. I raised the back up a touch. You know, the back I can always adjust as I want it. But that should be fine for now. I wanted it to have a little bit of a rake. I'm going with stock settings for now, and then I'll play around with camber once the car is at a good place. So Qbeams is just around the corner from where I do the wheel alignment, and he's got some very cool cars here. Bag all the things. Like, this is just cool. Like, the drift missile. I actually didn't speak about the exhaust on this car, so it's got a downpipe, 63mm. The downpipe goes into a 63mm, then from the 63 it goes to the exhaust that was on the car, which is 57, and then it goes into a box. And then it goes into 63, which is like the tiniest piece of 63, and then another box, and like basically a 63 exit. So that's what it is at the moment. I'm probably not going to change it. I think if I were to change it, I'll just do full 63, but it works as it is. I think it's okay. Quiet enough, it's not restricting power, it's not too much back pressure, so all good on the exhaust side. Just finished up, looking forward to driving a car with the straight steering wheel. I actually need to do the wagon as well because it's slightly off and it's bothering me, guys. I just had to bring the car back because the steering rack boot was too tight, so it kind of got caught up. So when turning right, it was super difficult. I actually thought that the steering rack was off-center. So last night when I drove it, I was like, flip, something is a mess. So brought it back. The guys here at Good Hope Tires, really great service. Sorted it out, no issues. I have 7 days. If there's any issues with the car, I can just bring it back and they'll sort it out. So good to go. So guys, I've been driving the car this week, just feeling it out, checking out what's up. I've picked up an oil leak. It looks like it's leaking from the oil return, but that shouldn't be a train smash. I'm just glad it's not like the sump or gearbox or anything like that. So that's all good, nothing to be concerned about. It's like a few drops overnight, so I just put a cardboard box under the engine bay just to collect that. Yeah, so that's cool. I'm actually on my way to Signal Hill now. I've been wanting to drive Signal Hill for a while, and I thought I'd wake up early before sunrise and take a drive up there. It's a public holiday. It is Good Friday, so the road should be nice and quiet. Starting today, and then I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna abort mission because I don't want to go up drive on the mountain on the wet road, it's just not going to be safe. So I'm going back home because I am tired. Yeah, so this guy so much jumped the robot.
Want to do a quick touch up on this bumper. It is very cracked at the bottom. It's because the car was lower and the bumper would flex and just crack. So I'm just gonna take some like touch up paint, which is nail polish, and that should do the trick. And that's an entire bottle of nail polish done, but I'm sure you won't be able to see much of a difference in the video. Like, it looks so much better now. Like, it's not perfect, obviously, but I'm going to have the front and rear bumper painted and fit as soon as possible. Like, I want the car looking as OEM as possible. Also, I don't want to attract the wrong attention. Hey guys, so I'm on my way to my storage location, aka my parents' garage. I just need to get some parts out for Matthew. He was in the previous video driving the Golf. So I've got some old pistons and stuff and the bottom end that he needs for a bit of a refresh on his 8-valve. So it's been a long time coming. I've really been wanting him to get the car sorted out, so that seems to be happening soon, which is really exciting. So I'm just trying to do what I can to make it happen. So this is the bottom end that I had ready to go. I say ready loosely, but yeah, this is a bottom end that my dad and I bought a good couple of months ago. It's a 2E block with 83mm Astina pistons in it. It looks like it has been pocketed. So it's going into an 8-valve, so I don't know, I think you might have to change the pistons. Yeah, I don't know why they painted it this color, but it's quite disgusting. And this is the ABF head that I had. And I've got, this is like, I don't know what cam this is. Which one is this? This is a ABT 300 degree solid lifter cam. So I've got some random bits and bobs, but I think I'll do another 16 valve at some point. Maybe with a bottom end that has a trigger wheel.
Hi there!
Guys, we are out at, I think it's Lakeside. Yeah, we're just taking a drive out. A couple of J2 guys, we just came around the mountain. So dark, but quite a lot of fun. We're gonna go around Chapman's Peak now, and I don't have my cap here, so I can't do like POV things, which is quite a bummer. Go, boy. That pops. That was caught behind me. Wild. I'm on my way back to Signal Hill this morning. Well, the other morning was just the bust, the rain was coming down and I didn't want to risk it. So this morning I'm slightly late and I kind of missed the sunrise. So that's also annoying, but maybe I'll still get some decent pictures and I'll get to drive the road, which is probably more important. Yo, it is pumping here today. Holy moly. It is a public holiday, so I mean, it's expected. But flip, look at this. Now and I'm not sure what that is. I don't know if it's just the way it's aligned. It could be, like, I wasn't even like slamming it, I just gently put it into third now and it put a bit of a grind there. So I'm not too sure what the deal is, so I just want to get some pictures. So the other night when we were out, this happened. So this is the fog light housing, basically the bulb and stuff, and it just started melting. I have no idea what happened or how this happened. I don't think it could be wiring related, but for some reason this just started melting. I didn't smell it. Like, as I was walking around, Jamil, them, they were checking out the car and, like, they smelt something funny. I thought it was just like PCV or something, and I didn't use the fogs for the few days I was driving the car. So I only used it that night because it was quite dark. It should be repairable, hopefully, because these things are quite expensive and this is a genuine Heller unit. So yeah, I really hope I can fix it. Thank you. coming down can be quite hairy because like there's not much runoff. If anything goes wrong, you are definitely going down the mountain. I find it so interesting how the weather is so different outside of town. Like, I just came from such nice sunny weather to this. It just looks so overcast, doom and gloom, and things go boom. Still smoking. It's like every now and then I just see a puff of smoke coming out the back, so it does look like the valve stems will have to be replaced. It's not urgent, but it will need to be replaced at some point. I think I'm just going to do a few more pulls. Take for granted. So yeah, that is awesome to have. Day for the first time, and it was such a laugh to be able to just spin it like that. Ah, I love this car, guys. This is such an epic swap. Flip, guys, that's it for this video. Thanks so much for watching. I know it's all over the place, but yeah, it's all part of the process. I'll catch you guys in the next one.